Hi everyone, thank you for the introductions. My name is Moses Sakashita. I'm an undergrad student in University of Tsukuba. And I am going to talk today about TelePresence user interface for puppetry that allows you to experience you as a puppet. This work was done with my professor Yoichi Ochai and other four students, Tatsuya, Emi, Ippei, and Keisuke. First, I'm going to show you a little bit what the system can do. This is a TelePresence interface for performing a puppetry. The TelePresence system transmits the performer's body and facial movements to a puppet and provides visual and audible feedback to the performer. Puppets and characters are used in various contexts, such as TV shows, attractions in theme parks, communication tools, and education tools. Puppets expressing thoughts and feelings have always attracted people and challenged their imagination. In a long history of puppetry, several methods for manipulating a puppet have been developed. Some of the simplest ways to perform puppetry include wearing a puppet directly on the hands and connecting strings between a puppet and a performer. But in most cases, performers manipulate a puppet with their hands above a table while the rest of the body is below the table. This poses a challenge in coordinating the actions. It is also hard to keep puppet's gaze in the right direction because you can only imagine what the puppet sees. So puppetry requires considerable training to manipulate a puppet. Another way to show puppet's presence is to wear a character costume covering their whole body. Please don't tell your children the secret. In this case, all you have to do for performance is to move your own body. Moreover, actors can look at what the character sees with their own eyes, and then they can have face-to-face interactions with the audience. It's quite easy to perform and play a role of it. However, all of these conventional methods have physical limitations. For example, puppeteers needed to perform exactly where the puppet is situated. Actors are required to be inside a costume to change expressions and motions, or they must be nearby a puppet or audience. It is also difficult for actors to manipulate both very tiny and very huge-sized characters and unique-shaped characters as well. Researchers proposed several input systems for animating a puppet, for example, using a webcam, tongue joystick device, and lip motion. Computational puppets are also designed basically for social communication. They facilitate communication at a distance among children and family using a puppet. But the main purpose of these puppets is to communicate with others at a remote, not to show performance to audience. And they don't focus on providing immersive experience that much. The concept of human to non-human immersive telepresence offers new experiences to performer and audience. Combining puppet shows and telepresence technology can remove the physical limitations, and puppets can be manipulated at the place where the performers want to be. Based on the idea, we proposed the telepresence system for puppetry. Performers are able to manipulate a puppet using their body, see the images from the puppet's eyes, and have a visual understanding of the puppet's ambient. This immersive experience allows them to act as if they became a puppet and enjoy performing. Moreover, beginners who are not trained to manipulate puppets can also perform a puppet show in an easy way using the system. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the implementation of the system. There are mainly two parts of the implementation. One is sensing and transmission part, and the other is audio-visual feedback part. First, I'm going to talk about the sensing and transmission. The robot's neck is controlled according to the performer's facial movements. We use head tracking sensors in the HMD to acquire the head rotation. The angles of rotation are sent to the submotors in the robot's neck. In addition, we also use the Kinect depth camera to capture the movements of the user's arms. We applied a low-pass filter to stabilize low-resolution and noisy input data from the Kinect sensor. The puppet synchronizes with the movements of the performer's arms. We implemented an array of 10 photoreflectors to detect the open or closed state of the performer's mouth. The array is used for detecting the lower lip's position. Based on the position, software controls the puppet's mouth. Inside the mask, there is also a microphone to capture the performer's voice. This gives the impression that the puppet is actually speaking to the audience. This figure is the visualized values of the sensors. You can see that the sub-motors are synchronized with the performer's mouth. Next, I want to talk about the audio-visual feedback. The robot carries two web cameras in place of its eyes. These cameras stream live video to the head-mounted display worn by the performer. So performers are able to see the images from the puppet's eyes with their own eyes to understand visual understanding of the puppet's environment. All the components of the puppet's bones are 3D printed, meaning that the robot can be designed at a relatively low cost. The puppet robot has two DOF arms, one DOF mouth, and two DOF neck. So the entire body of the puppet is a 7 DOF robot. I'm going to talk about user study we conducted to understand how the system affects the performer and audience. We need to investigate the effectiveness of the system in terms of both the performer side and audience side. For performers, it is crucial that the system is usable and enjoyable and not extremely exhausting. And from the perspective of the audience, it is also important that the puppetry using the system is fun and lifelike. At first, we investigated how performers felt when they performed puppetry using our system. We prepared a simple stage and asked participants to manipulate a puppet freely for a few minutes. And then we asked the participants to answer some questions about the usefulness and enjoyment. We compared the results between the beginners and experts who are familiar with hand manipulation. I want to show some of the results of the user studies. The first question pertained to operating a puppet from the puppet's point of view. Both participants rated it positively on an average. According to the participants' free descriptions, there were positive opinions to benefits of it. A professional puppeteer says that she usually tried to imagine the puppet's point of view, which is so hard. But with the system, she could see everything from the puppet's point viewpoint, and that was useful. A beginner says that he felt as if he became the character, which is similar feeling that when he wear a costume. The second question was about moving their body for manipulation. The statistical test showed that the difference was significant between general and professional participants. This result indicates that beginners who are not familiar with the hand manipulation feel easier to manipulate a puppet by the system, unlike professional puppeteers who are accustomed to the conventional method. One of professional puppeteers says that she could feel experience as if she became the puppet, and it was easier than by hand. A beginner mentioned that in a conventional method, he didn't have a technique to move its hands up and down. The third question was about the overall usefulness of the system. There was also a significant difference between professional puppeteers and beginners. Overall, the professional puppeteers rated the system neutrally, and we think that this is because they are already good at manipulating a puppet by hand, but are familiar with the system. A beginner mentioned that with the system, she could express her feelings. According to the comment, she felt like she became a puppet rather than manipulating it consciously. This question was about the enjoyment of the system. There was also no significant difference between professional puppeteers and beginners. In both professional and general participants, the averages were over 6 points. This result shows that all participants felt enjoyment using the system. Participants commented on their enjoyment of the system from different perspectives. One of professional participants enjoyed the experience of having the puppet's mouth synchronized with the user's mouth. And the others enjoyed seeing that the audience came close to the puppet. Secondly, we investigated how the audience felt when they saw the puppetry played with our system. We recorded videos of the hand-based and telepresence-based puppetry acted by professional puppeteers, and then asked participants to watch and compare these puppetries. We asked questions about the enjoyment, cuteness, and lifelikeness of each puppetry. The average scores of hand manipulation were higher than those of the system. But the statistical tests for each question showed that no significant difference existed between the system-based and hand-based puppetries. We think that the mechanical movements of the puppet and the sound of servo motors affected the results negatively. Next, I want to talk about several limitations of the current puppetry system. In conventional puppetry, a puppet can move around on the table freely, but the puppets manipulated by our system are fixed on a stage and cannot move from one end to another. Professional participants mentioned that they will become troubled when they use some props to tell a complicated story. To address this, we can use the center of gravity detection system like Nintendo Wii Fit, or simply other orientation detected by Kinect can be used for the movements on the table. Professional puppeteers really care about the appearance of the puppet. So it is useful for them to see how a puppet looks using our system. But the system allows only shows only the images from a first-person viewpoint and does not have any function to provide feedback for the state of its appearance. We think it is possible to design software to calculate and display the state of the puppet's body. We could also address this issue by showing images from a fixed point-to-point camera in the head-mounted display that capture the puppet objectively. Some participants also commented that the puppet looked mechanical or artificial somewhat because of the way it moves and the sound of the servo motors. The puppet is a 7DOF robot, and this is not sufficient to express subtle human motions. The system could address this issue by adding extra servo motors and regarding the sound of motors, playing some background music may mitigate the sound to some extent. Most participants feel some fatigue when they use the system. This is mainly because of VR sickness due to the latency of video displayed in the HMD and its weight. In future applications of telepresence system, omnidirectional cameras can be used to display a video remotely because the video can be cropped and displayed to users without being affected by the servo motors. But it might be also problematic because the viewpoint becomes slightly different from what a puppet actually sees. Hand-based puppetry can be performed at a low cost and in a small space, but the proposed system requires approximately 1.5 square meters for the performer side. This is because the system contains a depth camera, laptops, and other components. We could use algorithm for estimating human pose from RGB images that doesn't need wide space. The cost of the system is also relatively high because of these equipments. For the general public, the HMD can be replaced with a low-cost version such as Google Cardboard. Finally, I'm gonna talk a little bit about future work. Recently, in theme parks, interactive attractions with a 3D animated character are common, but there are rarely interactive attractions using physical puppets. The attractions using our technology could encourage repeat customers by changing the content each time they ride on the attraction. Our immersive telepresence system would also be useful and enjoyable for attending a conference or communicate with a family at a distance. We believe that the physical puppet allows remote attendees to express their thoughts and convey nonverbal information to others. So far, the bones of a puppet are manually designed and adjusted to the size of a puppet. In future work, it is very interesting if the bones inside a puppet were calculated computationally, given several parameters like its size and number of joints. In summary, we implement an immersive telepresence system for puppetry and conduct several user studies to investigate how the system affects the performer and audience. The results show that the system facilitates the manipulation of puppets, especially for beginners, and the system allows all performers to enjoy performing puppetry. Finally, we conclude by discussing the limitations of the system and possibilities for future work beyond puppetry. This is the list of research members of this project. I really thank all the members who work together. We'll give our demonstration this evening, so please do come and experience you as a puppet in the demo session. Any questions are welcome. Thank you.
Hi, Jeremy Warner from UC Berkeley. So thank you for presenting this work. Often puppeteers may control multiple puppets at one time, but this is, I think, just one puppet, one puppeteer. Do you think that this would be possible to extend to maybe like controlling two puppets simultaneously, or do you think that's infeasible?
Yeah, I think this is maybe, this is one of our possibilities, application, because the current system is sending the data to only one puppet, but it can be expanded to like two puppets or three puppets at the same time. I think it is possible, and it will like expand the entertainment. And yes, I think so too. Yes.
Hi, Sol Ro, Iria Bordeaux, France. So I really love it. I have a question about hybrid approaches. Did you think about keeping the helmet while being still under the table, or for example, I don't know, having a, no, mostly that. Do you think about that, having the helmet but staying in the same position like that? Do you think it makes sense? Just for the feedback without the actuation, let's say. Do you understand?
Maybe I'm sorry.
It's okay. I will ask you at the demo reception.
You said you sorry. Can just have the helmet, but you're under the table. Is that a good scenario?
Why the
It's okay. I will ask you later.
Sorry.
No.